hit the ego of all the academic Muslims, and even you weekend coursers. I teach weekend courses. It's going to hit all of our egos. What's the number one most beneficial thing for us in this room? And I'm going to say it. Yes, I'm going to say it. Before you start wearing hijab, before you grow a beard, before you dress religious, learn to read the Book of God. I mean like Alif Bata. I mean like Abadan, Khalaqa. Learn to pronounce the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before you get into a intellectual debate about the use of the term anthropomorphism in the religion of Islam. Is Allah sitting on a throne, or is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is it metaphysical? You know what, fam? If you can't spell it, don't use it. And if you don't know what it means, don't flex. Because let's face it, sorry sisters, us brown folk, we're not very muscular, right? So we can't wear the tight shirts and look down. So what we do is we put on black glasses, maybe a kifaya or maybe some bishon coat. I'll translate bishon later. And we walk around saying things like mazahib, fiqh, hanafi shafi, Islam, al-maghrib, zaytuna hamza yusuf, Islam, Islam, Quran, and brother Wissam. And we, oh, and then we do this, bishon. And that's for real. So what I would say to us, five beneficial things. Learn to read the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like literally pick up Alif Bata. And if you don't know, I'm going to be talking about it later. I'll tell you the story later when Maulana Abdul Nasir is here. We can learn to read now. There's literally the technology for anyone who doesn't know the letters to learn to read in 8 days. Number two, learn to pronounce the book. Let's be real here. If I came up here and I started talking in an uneducated accent, right? So the guy, one guy in high school, he was like, oh, how do you do that with your, he asked my sister, how do you type out this essay? And she's like, oh, I typed it on my computer. For real. He goes, man, I'm about to get myself a Puda. Yeah, a Puda. Computer. I'm about to get myself a Puda. For real. Point is, now that sounds uneducated here. Can you imagine if you open the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you're discussing these intellectual strong things about the difference between Makkin and Madinan Quran and whether the Mushaf of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud matched the Mushaf in the second generation of Muslims during the last Caliphate? What? Who? What? Bro, can you read? Can you read Abadan? If you can, I'm gonna keep those words to myself.